G'day ladies and gents, and welcome back to DCS World and RAZBAM's upcoming module, the AV-8B Night Attack Harrier 2. So today, rather than just a flight and basic weapons demonstration, I've put together a little mission to demonstrate one of the AV-8B's most interesting capabilities, the ability to perform SEED missions. SEED, or Suppression of Enemy Air Defense missions, involve the disruption or elimination of enemy air defenses. This includes a wide range of targets, but the most common are hostile radar stations and SAM sites. For today's mission, we'll be flying SEED for a two-ship flight of A-10Cs against a small Red Force encampment at the entrance to a valley to our north. The encampment has at least one mobile surface-to-air missile site, along with a number of mobile ZU-23 anti-aircraft guns providing air defense over a small force of T-72 main battle tanks currently being refueled and resupplied at the location. Our primary mission is to enter the valley and attempt to eliminate the SAM sites with our AGM-122 sidearm anti-radiation missiles, ahead of the Warthogs clearing the way for them to engage the anti-aircraft guns and the T-72s. As a secondary objective, we are also carrying four Zuni rocket pods to engage any targets of opportunity we find in the AO. Now, I designed this mission to allow for two attempts to take out the SAM site prior to the arrival of the A-10s. The first attempt will be approaching via the valley. If I manage to achieve lock and release, or fail to achieve lock on the SAM site in this first pass, there's a break in the valley wall on the east side. This break will allow me to get behind the mountain range that makes up the east side of the valley and circle around to the northern side of the encampment. From this position, I'll be able to either confirm the destruction of the SAM site, or I'll be given one additional opportunity to be able to take out the SAM site prior to the arrival of the A-10s. Should I miss on this second attempt, I have to abort the A-10s attack, otherwise they will be destroyed by the SAM site. So from here, I'm going to switch over to the in-flight voiceover from while I was actually performing the mission itself. Until the end, ladies and gents, I hope you enjoy. And 9.5 miles to waypoint 3. I'm pretty sure everything is set here. I'll set the weapon systems as we come over the mountain range. For anybody watching this, if you look at the right-hand side midsection of the HUD, you'll see waypoint 3 and a number in front of it, currently 6.0. That is the range to the next waypoint and what waypoint we're going on. The navigation system in this is actually really easy to work with. I'm still in the process of trying to work out exactly how the hell to program in waypoints mid-flight, but managing pre-programmed waypoints is very, very simple. Zero to waypoint 3, so we'll be just about ready to change over to waypoint 4. Waypoint 4 will bring us across the mountains. I'll arm the sidearms at that point. And then waypoint 5 will bring us directly onto the target area. We'll begin our bank. Seven to target. And there we go. Alright, master arm on. Select sidearms. Select air ground mode. And go back to nav mode. Sidearms are ready for deployment. God, these things are easy to use. Alright, so as simple as that, that's all it takes to get the sidearms ready to go. Currently we are in master mode navigation. All I've got to do is flick us to master mode air ground, and at that point the sidearms are instantly ready to fire. So we can continue following the nav points at this time, and as we pull and line up with nav 5, I will go to master mode air ground, and at that point we are pretty much, well, at that point we're just waiting for the SAM site to actually paint us with radar. And hopefully we'll get a lock. There's is change over to navigation point 5. I'm going to bank out wide here. I'm going to go around the west side of this hill in the end of the valley, and let's go over to annoying buzzy air ground mode. God, these things make some noise. On the upside, there is absolutely no way you couldn't know you have these things actually armed. Lock, release. Countermeasures. Get low and head for that valley wall. We got a lock on that early. We got a lock on that much earlier than I was expecting. We didn't even make it to the breakpoint. Hopefully that one will still hit. RWR is clear. I'm not seeing any smoke trails from the SAM site coming in this direction. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to see whether or not that missile actually landed home until we get around the back of this mountain range and come back on it from the north. The upside is that mountain range will take anything that they decide to try and fire at us, or prevent them from being able to fire at us in the first place. There. So we're just going to get a little bit closer up to the far end. I don't want to come over the top of the mountains. It'll leave me exposed if the SAM site is still active. Just where the mountain starts to taper out on the far end, we'll be able to bank around and we'll still be able to use the mountains as some form of cover while I do a little visual recon to actually see whether or not we hit the target, or whether or not we're going to try and get a lock with the second sidearm. Start bringing it around slowly. Should be far enough to the north side now. Still no visual. That should be roughly where the camp is there. And sidearm is not finding anything, there is nothing on RWR. And there it is, pillar of smoke. We hit the target, so the SAM site has been eliminated. So we can get rid of the sidearm now, we don't need that one. What we do need now is to select the Zuni rockets. There we go, Zunis are now armed. And we're going to keep to about this distance until the A-10s have moved into position and began engaging the anti-aircraft guns with their Mavericks. The 23mm will make a hell of a mess of this aircraft if we get too close. Just gotta watch the sky for the smoke trails. I doubt we'll see the A-10s from here, but we should see the smoke trails from... And that looks like a couple of smoke trails. zoom in. Thank you. And this looks like we missed the explosions, but there's three new smoke pillars down there at the moment. So the A-10s are in the area, they have engaged. And it looks like they've gone for the anti-aircraft guns first, which is excellent. We can start getting ourselves ready for our approach now. Now the A-10s were meant to engage the anti-aircraft guns first, pull out, and then go for the T-72s, and from there they will freely engage anything. I, however, am a terrible shot with rockets. Part of the reason why I wanted them on this loadout is for practice. So I'll be perfectly honest, I'll be happy with anything that I manage to hit. Alright, so, flaps down one step, we've got the nozzles at 45, throttling back, this should give us a nice slow pass for rocket release, hopefully pretty close to optimal engagement speed. Alright, now where are they going to go? Are they going to go high? Oh no, they were pretty close, alright, so, I'm a bit close now, alright, how about we pull out of here now? That was deeper than I wanted to go. Those first rockets were a lot closer than I was expecting. Nozzles are back up, flaps are retracted. That actually looked like a fairly decent pass. And it sounds like either bombs or Mavericks from the A-10s hitting right after we went through. Alright, so what we're going to do is have a nice wide pass here, stay away from the A-10s while they're doing what they do, and let's see, how many rockets do we actually have on board at the moment? I didn't lost count how many I actually fired. So, exit here. Yeah, we're good for another pass. We'll make one more pass and then we'll do a recon flight past the site just to see exactly how much damage we've done. And at that point, I think it's time for this seed mission to pack up and go home. And that is a lot of smoke there. So flaps down, nozzles are at 45, so we should be getting into a nice release speed again. They're close. Ooh, we definitely got something in there. I think that may have been one of the fuel trucks. And that is all of our rockets spent because we've auto-selected the sidearm as it's the last thing we've got left on board short of the cannon. Alright, so that's us into master mode navigation, so we no longer have the screeching of the sidearm in our ears anymore. That place is a mess. Alright, so let's get the left-hand side MFD back to navigation. We're going to make a long right-hand bank around here, nice and clear, although I don't imagine there's much left in that site that can actually shoot at us anymore. But better to be safe than, you know, a crater in the middle of the desert. We'll do a long flight pass just to have a look. I'm not going to fold up this one, I'm just going to go past at cruise speed. Take a look at exactly what's left of the base, and then we'll proceed to navigation point 6, which will take us back to our runway. And, oh, yep. Looks like possibly one, maybe two supplier refueling trucks managed to survive the attack. All the T-72s are down, the air defenses are down, everything else has been eliminated. Well, that worked out better than I was expecting. Okay, so at this point, we are 61 miles from waypoint 6, which will then turn us to waypoint 7, taking us to our home runway. And waypoint 6 is almost directly west of our current location. So, yeah, this is going to take 15 or 20 minutes to get home, I reckon. And like that, with the magic of editing, we skipped through 15 to 20 minutes worth of flight time to get to the landing. Which was... well, you'll see. I'm getting better at putting the Harrier down more gently, but I'm still a long way away from being able to put this thing down on the back of a moving destroyer. Anyways, I hope you found that engagement interesting. It was only a smaller mission just to test exactly how some of the systems worked as a little bit more of an elaborate display. I'm going to be expanding on that mission and adding a few new bases, so I actually have to supply seed to multiple targets over time, and I might actually do that again in a future video. Anyways, there is one last thing that I wanted to cover here before we moved on to the end of the video. It was something I was asked a little bit in the comment section of the last video, and something I've been asked a little bit of in between, the sounds for the Harrier. The sounds for the Harrier in this current early access build are placeholders. These are not the final sounds that the Harrier will have on release. I have been told that I may potentially get access to another build that will have the final sounds at some point in the future, but I do not have a time frame for this at this point. So don't worry, anybody who's sort of going, hey, that doesn't sound quite like it should, yeah, these are just the placeholders for the in-development build, not the finalized sounds. Anyways, ladies and gents, hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you very much for watching. As always, if you would like to help out the channel, please feel free to check out my link to Patreon in the video description down below. Otherwise, remember to subscribe to Twitch and follow me on social media. And until next time, fly smart, fly safe, and I'll catch you in the skies.